with that boat up high. Turn them all to the sky.
I didn't realize you were walking.
Oh. Oh, you wanted us to stop?
No.
Oh.
I mean, with the guitar.
I thought this was a recovery walk, not a recovery stop.
My liver went down to about 62%. I went from still playing rugby in England at 190 down to about 118 pounds. My back seized, my organs quit out. And I realized that my life was quickly coming to an end, solely through choices, solely through selfishness, solely through a desire to find that next moment, that next escape from what I didn't want to know. And as I began to really reflect on those times of my sickness, I realized what I didn't want to know wasn't only the truth I found in Christ, but it was me. I hated myself.
But you're not saying anything. Oh, no. are sealed. Say something once. Why say it again? Come on, boys. A psycho killer.
I don't care how old you are. I don't care how young you are. Tomorrow is never promised. You don't learn to live with the heartache. You adjust. You never forget. And everything reminds you. Every one of you people is somebody's child, somebody's brother, somebody's sister, somebody's mother, somebody's father. These people love you and they need you.
I thought recovery just meant stop drinking and drug. So I get into the treatment center and I find out I have a disease, and this disease affects me mentally, physically, and spiritually.
The way I kind of got involved in right now the epidemic of the opiates, it was probably about 6 or 7 years ago, I was involved in building Naomi's house. Steve Carroll's around here somewhere. His ears probably perked up when I gave him the plug here for Naomi's house, but it's an awesome project. Our church, Cornerstone, actually built a house. And due to some unforeseen circumstances, we couldn't keep it going. But MBH has recently bought that, and it's a recovery house for women and babies. Awesome thing. And I put a lot of blood, sweat, and tears into that, and it really began to, when I started, was building that, and I knew what it was going to be for. I mean, even back then, we knew it was going to be a recovery house. We just didn't know what shape or form it was going to take. Put a lot of blood, sweat, and tears into it. And then through my work at the fire department, when the opiate epidemic hit, I started seeing the devastation it was having on our community, stressing the resources. I seen the looks on my guys' faces as they would come back from runs, and they said, yeah, we were up at Johnny's house, and we've been there 10 times in the last 2 weeks shooting Narcan into him. And they were getting really hardened to that. And it's easy to lose that compassion when you're out there doing that.
He called me the other day, and he said, Terry, we need to do something, and we're going to put you on a commission to see what we can do to help those with mental illness in the state. And for about 2 months, all we did was meet, talk about everything there is, and a report came out. And I've been in this business 46 years, so report after report. But there were three things that I want to talk about. We need crisis. We need centers where people, when they have these illnesses, they have somewhere to go. I know you have a great hospital here that you can go to, but we need crisis centers all over this state. The other is housing. You can't get better if you don't have a roof over your head, food in your belly, and somebody knows your name. You just can't get any better. And so we need more housing. And then the big thing, and this is the biggest thing in the governor's budget, and by the way, we're going to be voting on that budget in the latter part of May. We have $560 million for mental health and addiction care in our school system for kids. We have to keep that there. We hear the Senate's going to try to cut it. We can't let that happen, because if we don't start treating kids, only 25% of kids with a diagnosable mental illness get any care at all. That's a travesty in this state, and we've got to do something about it, and we are. I'm going to be real short here because it's going to start raining, and the band's better than the speakers anyway. I just want to tell you, this is a tremendous thing to do, to have people come back and show that recovery works. My favorite people in the world, Pat Quinn. One of my favorite people in the world is Pat Quinn, because he represents everything good about NAMI, everything good about recovery, because it shows that people can recover and live productive lives. So God bless you all. Recovery. Thank you for having me.
I have a group of guys and gals
they call themselves WAR, which actually the acronym is We Are, you know, is WAR. And if you ever get a chance to go to any of their events, go to them. It's all about fun. Recovery is fun. And we start and we continue to bring all of those people who are recovery carriers together. Okay, everybody, have a good day. Stay dry. Check out this band. Yay! And most importantly, a big yay to everybody who's in recovery.
Yeah!